No matter how the rest of the year has been, many people look forward to the holiday season as a time of joy and comfort. Traditions like meeting Santa, family dinner, and decorating a Christmas tree become important rituals. Imagine a family going out to pick a tree, or finally bringing out the artificial one they store all year just for this special occasion, meticulously decorating it with shiny baubles and pretty lights, and finding the perfect spot for it in their home, only for a catastrophic disaster to take it all away in less than a minute. This happened to a family in Wales who, just days after getting their tall fir tree ready for Christmas, watched as the flames it caused burned away their holiday dreams. In December 2018, a young family in Wales was getting ready for one of the most wonderful times of the year, Christmas. Nicola and Bradley Jackson had two young daughters, Nia and Eva, aged 9 and 6, and sweet little dog, Bella. The family was excitedly preparing for a holiday full of joy, presents, and quality time together. They had just gotten the perfect Christmas tree for their home. It was a lush, sturdy, 6-foot fir tree that smelled wonderful and looked beautiful in their living room. The Jacksons spent a magical evening decorating their tree with shining balls, bright lights, and sparkly stars. A few days later, Nicola put Nia and Eva to bed and settled in for the night while Bradley watched a movie downstairs. Hours later, around 11 p.m., Nicola was startled awake by the sound of Bella barking like crazy. She groggily went downstairs to see what happened and froze, horrified at what she saw. But before we get into that, have you ever wanted to try out the hottest new fragrances out there? This video sponsor, Scentbird, is a fragrance subscription service that lets people try a new scent every month. Whether you're just beginning your fragrance journey or already know the exact impression you want to give, take a short quiz on Scentbird's website to find your ideal match and get it delivered right to your door. For only $17 a month, you can even skip a delivery if you feel like you have enough scents one month. Try classic scents from the master perfume houses of Prada, Versace, and Dolce & Gabbana, or discover exciting new brands like Sanctuary, which only uses ingredients that don't harm animals or the environment. This month, we got to try Dolce & Gabbana's Light Blue Per Homme, a wonderful scent to remind you of light and sunny summer days. The next bottle is Bespoke by Joseph Aboud, a masculine fragrance that makes you feel sophisticated and classy. Last but not least, we have North Atlantic Right Whale from Sanctuary. It conjures up images of the ocean with sea greens and bright mandarin notes, looking for the perfect gift for anyone that's affordable, great for everyday use and special occasions, and 100% customizable. Bottles of designer brand perfume can cost hundreds of dollars, but you can smell just as luxurious for just over $7. Click our link in the description and use our coupon code BREWS2 to get 55% off your first month at Scentbird. She groggily went downstairs to see what happened and froze, horrified at what she saw. Their beloved Christmas tree was up in flames, filling the air with smoke. The air was becoming thick and unbreathable, and the fire was spreading. Nicola sprinted back upstairs to grab her daughters and husband, but Bradley wasn't there. He had fallen asleep on the couch by the fire and hadn't woken up. Nicola ran to open one of the kids' bedrooms, but the door handle broke off. Her heart skipped a beat. Thankfully, her daughter was able to open the door, and Nicola escaped with her children. But she couldn't give up on her husband. Though she was crying, terrified, and thought there was no way he was okay in the living room, she ran back into the burning building to rescue Bradley. Nicola found him and dragged him out by the arm. Bella, the family pet who first noticed the fire, also made it out safely. The Jacksons were lucky and grateful to be alive and safe, but had to watch helplessly as flames consumed their home, destroying their belongings and their presents they had lovingly picked, leaving them homeless for Christmas. As you may have guessed, the culprit was the glittering Christmas tree that had given the Jacksons so much joy. This is more common than people may think. U.S. fire departments respond to around 160 Christmas tree fires every year, according to the National Fire Protection Association. You might think you're safe if you use an artificial tree, but that's not totally correct. According to research by Underwriters Laboratories, a pre-lit artificial tree can be just as dangerous as a dry, natural tree, though the number of fires from real trees do outnumber artificial ones by a 3-to-1 ratio. Even if an artificial tree is flame retardant or resistant, if the fire burns hot or long enough, the protection wears off and the whole tree can catch fire. 160 fires make up only a small fraction of total house fires, but a blazing Christmas tree is very dangerous and more likely to be life-threatening. This is because they burn so fast. Instead of a few flames gathering momentum and giving time for smoke alarms and human detection, a Christmas tree on fire becomes an inferno in seconds. A dried-out tree flashes over in flames in less than 1 minute, catching and spreading faster than newspaper. There are several reasons for the rapid burn rate. The trees have a large surface area and a porous structure that allows more oxygen to be pulled in to feed the fire. To add to this, festive trees are often placed near flammable curtains, gifts, furniture, and rugs. Though both real and artificial trees are very combustible, artificial trees add another layer of complications as the plastics mean different burning behaviors like melting and dripping. Christmas tree fires cause an average of 2 deaths, 12 injuries, and $10 million in property damage per year. Almost 1 in 5 of those fires were caused by the decorative lights on the tree. In 20-25% of all cases, a heat source, like a candle or electrical equipment, was too close to the tree. These holiday fires also have a high fatality rate, resulting in death once every 31 incidents. Even without Christmas trees, festive decorations still cause several home fires, around 790 of them per year. Candles are to blame in 1/3 of these incidents, and cooking was responsible for another 19% of them. It's important to be informed and help others be aware of these dangers to prevent accidents. In a tragic inferno only last year, a dried-out natural Christmas tree caught fire in a Philadelphia row house that was home to several relatives of the same family. Up to 18 people lived or stayed there at various times. The three-story building, located near the Philadelphia Museum of Art, belonged to the city's public housing agency. Inside the home, there were 6 smoke alarms, but none of them were actually working. Most of them were reportedly removed in the time since the city's last inspection the year before. One alarm in a common basement did work, but by the time it activated, it was too late. Less than 5 minutes after the first emergency call, firefighters were on the scene, but the situation was already dire. Fire Commissioner Adam Teal said there was zero visibility when they arrived, and the temperature at the ceiling reached almost 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit. The whole building was filled with toxic smoke, which poses a threat even if someone survives an initial fire. Firefighters did their utmost to save the family. They found one person alive inside, but the individual sadly passed away at the scene. Out of 14 people in the house, 13 of them were on the third floor at the time of the fire, and 12 of them lost their lives. One man miraculously survived by jumping out of a third-floor window. The only other survivor was a 5-year-old boy who was on the same floor as the Christmas tree. After investigating, firefighters discovered that the 5-year-old boy had been playing with a lighter around the time the tree caught fire. Investigators believe that the lighter was responsible for the tree catching fire, but didn't place the blame on anyone. Unfortunately, due to the various reasons Christmas tree fires burn so fast, the situation became a disaster within seconds. 3 sisters and 9 of their children perished in the tragic accident, making it the deadliest fire in Philadelphia in over 100 years. The Jacksons were lucky that they all survived, along with their little dog, and were all together. But they were traumatized, having lost everything they owned. And their home was damaged by the flames and thick black smoke. It would be weeks before they could move back, and they had to stay in a hotel in the meantime. So Nia and Eva were worried that Santa wouldn't visit them since they didn't have a house. Thankfully, there was an outpouring of support for the Jacksons, whose friends, family, and community have brought them food, clothes, and messages of support. A page for donations was set up to help the Jacksons, and the children received coloring books and pencils from their school as gifts. With Christmas coming up, these stories might be a little concerning, but there's no need to ditch the trees and decorations in a panic. We just have to be more careful when decorating and remember some important prevention tips. The first tip concerns the tree itself. For people who like to decorate their house with real trees, a fresh one is ideal, as a dried out tree will catch and spread fire quickly. This is why forest fires are so dangerous during a dry spell without any rain. Check your tree by combing your fingers through the branches regularly, and see if the needles stay on or come off really easily. If they fall off quickly, it means the tree is dry and it's time to dispose of it. Another sign of freshness is sap on the trunk of the tree. To make sure the tree takes water in well, make a fresh cut on the stump or ask the tree vendor to do it. Once it's in your home, water it immediately and daily for as long as it takes in water. A dry tree can go up in flames in less than 10 seconds. And flashover takes only about a minute. But in a well-watered tree, the flames are contained to one section of burning branches. Don't let it go dry, as you can't return it back to the same state afterwards. If you're going with artificial trees, look for a flame retardant one. Though you might be excited and bursting with holiday cheer, buying a tree too early in the season means a higher risk of drying out over time. Similarly, try not to let your tree hang out in your home too long after the holidays. And take it down sooner rather than later to be safe. Experts recommend keeping live trees for a maximum of 4 weeks. An important factor is the placement and arrangement of the tree. Decorations, electrical devices, heat sources, and surrounding furniture should all be carefully considered when putting up a Christmas tree. It should be placed away from heating ducts, fireplaces, and other heat sources. As for decorations, candles on or near the tree are a big no-no. And if you've been hanging on to the same fairy lights since the 80s, consider that it might not be the safest option. For electric lights, LEDs are safer and they don't produce lots of heat. No matter what style you choose, check all the strings of lights carefully before you hang them, as they can have water damage or signs of chewing from rodents. Any frayed, chewed, or cracked cords should be thrown away, and loose and broken bulbs need to be replaced. Pay attention to the manufacturer's instructions for wattage and the maximum number of lights that can be connected. Also remember not to tuck the cords under a tree skirt, area rug, or anything else flammable. Though it might be pretty, it's best not to leave the lights on unattended, so turn them off before going to bed or leaving the house. As for the other decorations, try not to use pine cones or anything else flammable that could fuel a fire. Finally, always make sure you have well-placed smoke detectors that are working well, and a fire safety plan in mind in case the worst happens. The holidays are a time when people feel extra cozy and safe in their homes. And the last thing on your mind is the possibility of a terrible accident. But if you follow some simple precautions and take appropriate safety measures, you can keep yourself from worrying too much and just relax and enjoy the season. Unless you're me. The holidays always give me a headache, and it doesn't help that everyone always tells me I have something called resting Grinch face. Remember, use our code BREWS2 to get 55% off your first month at Scentbird and try exciting new scents today.